Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. On the previous episode, we finished up the key cavern here, but so many of you in the comments were like, Josh, you missed the chest and it's 200 rupees, not a key. And I believe many of you called me a dumbass, probably. I don't know, I was calling myself a dumbass because I need to get rupees as much as, you know, the next guy. Except that the next guy, I killed him and took his rupees, so poor guy. anyway, so you know, we couldn't have gotten this without the Pegasus boots that we got in this dungeon. We actually should have come back here, and I didn't, and I feel bad. We actually need to come up here and kill this red guy off, because we need to kill every enemy in this room. And obviously the little red guy's just kind of chilling over there, doing nothing. Kind of just being chill, being trapped behind everything. And there's no way to get there without the Pegasus boots, so please die, Mr. Skeleton. And with that, we have 200 rupees. You're ecstatic. I am ecstatic. We need as many rupees as we can freaking get, so thank you guys for pointing that out, because otherwise I probably would have not gone back to it. Anyway, so let's leave the dungeon again, because we need to make our way to the next place. We need to make our way to... Well, I don't know. Let's find out. Hey there, Owl. Tell me where I need to go.
Hoot, how many instruments have you gotten so far? When you play the instruments in front of the egg, the windfish will wake and you will leave this island. Now you must hasten to Yarna Desert. The dark, monstrous inhabitants of the sand will show you the way, Hoot Hoot.
The dark, monstrous inhabitants of the sand will show me the way. I highly doubt that they will show me the way. I'm gonna have to forcibly take it from their ass. But, you know, it's a nice thought, at least. So we do. He says we need to go to the desert, which is on the, I think, on the west side of the island. So we'll make our way there. We have quite a few things we need to do first, though. Fair amount of things. Let's bomb this this way, though, because we're actually going to have to come back this way later. So we might as well get that out of the way now. Hey there, Taryn. How's it going? Oh, Josh, I see you have a nice stick. Don't you be talking about my stick, bro. There's a strict bro code where we don't talk about each other's sticks. Can I borrow it for a second? Yeah, you can borrow my stick, you damn pervert. What are you doing? What reason do you have for poking a beehive? Of course the bees are gonna chase you, dumbass. All right, fine, Jesus. He took my stick, and now I need to trade it for a honeycomb. I guess that's not so bad. Honeycombs tend to be kind of tasty. You dumbass. All right, Jesus. I don't need to go in that cave. That's just a fairy fountain. Friggin' A. What reason does he have to poke the honey? I guess he wants to eat it, maybe. Taryn seems to be getting himself into a lot of trouble, though, because he ate those mushrooms or whatever, and turned into a raccoon, of all things. A magic raccoon. Oh my god, ouch, get out of my face. So, in this cave here, there's quite a few secrets that I'm going to be picking up in this episode as well. Not necessarily secret seashells, but there's actually, I think, a couple pieces of heart in this episode, of all things. This is not a piece of heart, this is a rupee. Although my heart is made of money. So, that's basically a piece of heart for me. But if you have bombs, this is just really random, but there's this place in the wall you can bomb here to get a piece of heart. And I always felt that like stuff like that was really, really weirdly placed and weirdly random. I never really liked that, because I always wonder how people discover that stuff. I mean, maybe if you have enough time and you just kind of play the game and you really enjoy the game, you discover stuff like that. But like, I'm thinking back to like Zelda 1. There's a ton of just hidden caves and stuff with rupees and money and stuff, and like, I just always wonder how people discovered that stuff. It's just, I don't know. It's like, before the internet and stuff, before there's a collective, like, some people would discover all of that stuff themselves and then network it, and like, I don't know, I feel like... I've tried to play the game recently, I'm just overwhelmed by the amount of hidden things there are in the wall. Oh my god, I'm moonwalking! Look at me moonwalk, mommy! I'm moonwalk! Aw, the bush got in my way of my moonwalk. Aw, man. That was awesome, though. I was moonwalking. Friggin' Michael Jackson all up in this bitch. Alright, anyway, Moving on, we're back in Mabe Village, which is not the desert. But like I said, there's a few things we need to get out of the way first. Now that we have the Pegasus, we can come here and get an item that we couldn't get before by jumping in bed with Marin. She's not anywhere to be seen, so don't worry about that. We are in a dream world or something. I assume this is a dream world. With the Pegasus boots, these enemies here are infinitely easier to kill. They mirror your movements, as you can see. And do quite a bit of damage. I think they do 2 hearts if you get hit by them. Which is why, like, every one of these drops a heart. Because if you come here without... Oh, hey, this is a good time to show this off. If you pause the game while you're holding a Guardian Acorn, when you pick it up, or a piece of power, somebody pointed out in the comments that you pause the game, and unpause it, it skips the dialogue. So, yeah. And with that, we have an extra 100 rupees. I am happy. I'm happy with my 100 rupees. I'm not ecstatic, though, apparently. Apparently, I'm only ecstatic when I get 200 rupees. But like I said, you can come here without the Pegasus Boots and get those rupees, but if you have the Pegasus Boots, you can come up here and get... a red potato! You've got the ocarina. You should learn to play many songs. Many, many songs, or at least 3. Because there's only 3 that you possibly can learn. Because Link is very limited when it comes to his knowledge of music, so there's really only a couple things that he could possibly play. But there is a song that we can pick up right away. Hey there, Marin. How's it going? How's it going, girl?
Hey, that's a nice ocarina you have there. Will you accompany me as I sing?
Doesn't it just warm your heart? I know it warms mine.
So, how do you like it? It's really touching, isn't it? Does it stick in your mind?
No, it doesn't! Who are you again? I don't remember anything! No, yeah, it does. If you say no, you have to play the whole song again, and that's annoying. You've learned the Ballad of the Windfish. This song will always remain in your heart, and... as you can tell, it's going to be a very important song. It is called Battle of the Windfish, and that's kind of where we're going, is to wake the Windfish. So clearly the Battle of the Windfish is a very important song. And it's kind of like the theme of this game, kind of like how Zelda's Lullaby is like sort of the theme of Ocarina of Time. Like, I feel like every Zelda game sort of has that one song. But anyway, Battle of the Windfish is an important song, so it's kind of cool that we're learning it so early on. We still got quite a bit left to go in the game, so... alright, anyway, with that, let's go to the library real fast. I want to check something out. Because there's this book here. And now that we have the Pegasus Boots, we could knock this book down. Hey there. Do you want to read this book?
Yes. New World of Color, Under the 5 Gravestones. 3 up, 4 left, right even. 5 up, 2 left, 1 down. Try with all your might. Open a new path. Whoever is worthy receives the power of color. I wonder what the world of color is.
Me too. I guess we'll find out in the next episode. But that's kind of a cool thing that we need to get out of the way now and just look at, because that is going to tell us how to get into the next dungeon. So that is important. But before we go and do that, we are actually going to go back to the first dungeon in the game and, yes, get another secret seashell. It's actually not in the dungeon at all. Link? Generally not a good idea to just leap into freaking holes. It's not in the dungeon. Our secret seashell is hidden in this tree outside the dungeon now that we have the Pegasus Boots. There's actually quite a few things that we can get now that we have the Pegasus Boots, honestly. There's a lot of places that we can go now. And new stuff that we've unlocked. But that's, I guess that's generally the case with all of the items in Zelda games. And I feel like that's an important progression. I think that's why I like the handheld Zelda games a lot more than the 3D ones, because I feel like they rely on the items a little bit more to get around the world rather than just, oh, you unlock this area now kind of thing. I feel like some of the later Zelda games have kind of fallen into that, where like, oh, you're just progressing the story and you get to this place now. But that's not the case with some of these older ones. Like, the whole map feels like it's sort of available right from the start, but it's not at all. And then as you progress and get unlock items, you unlock a bunch of new areas. Now, I want to make a point of this. I want to activate this. I think I already activated this, but I'm going to activate it again, this warp here. Just because it's going to be very, very useful very shortly, and I just want to make sure that I didn't already not do it, because I can't remember if I did or not. So, very important to have that that activated, because we will be going back and forth from Maid Village to a new village that we're going to head to right now, actually. We're making our way. Oh, God. Please get out of my life. Thank you. We're going to a new town. Brand new world we live in. And, I think it's down... Is it down here? Yes, it is down here. Now that we have the Pegasus boots, there's a secret hidden hole we can go through. We can't cross this river here, clearly, without another item. But, hidden here underneath this... I can't talk today. I can't talk ever. Good lord. Now that we have the Pegasus boots, we can actually cross this river underneath it. In the channel. Don't go up. I always... Oh, goodness. I always go up here for some reason, and I have no idea why. Like, there is stuff up there, but it won't be quite some time that we go up there. So, I don't know why I always do that, but the village that we want is down here. Right here. Look at that. Welcome to the Animal Village. Yeah, so we'll go in there in a minute, but before that, down here... Oh, God, I hate this. Oh, there's so many enemies that you can't easily kill like this in this game. Good lord. And that guy, too. All the freaking enemies, everything on the screen is an enemy. Even the rocks are enemies. Damn it. And these buzz blobs are on, like, every map here. Jesus. Sorry, I'm ranting about the enemies. But I do think that they are fun to kill. Secrets are like water when it comes to bridges. You'd think that this guy is talking about the secret seashell. But in fact, he is not at all talking about the sea. Oh god, Zoras, Zoras, Zoras! Good lord. Don't shoot at me. He's not talking about the secret seashell. He's talking about another secret that we'll get back to later. A lot of stuff we're getting back to. That book, that owl statue. We're getting a lot. We're gonna come back to some of this stuff later. Let's try not to die here. Although I believe I still have that potion from Crazy Tracy, so we should be alright. Anyway, let's go to Animal Village. Let's talk to some people in Animal Village and see what's up. Sigh. It's such a nice day. We need a song from Marin. Okay. Well, I don't know. Let's go in here and see. I'm curious about the village's inhabitants. They're all animals, so. You're in a desert? There's a way to get there to the south, but you might not be able to get through if that lazy walrus is in the way. What, lazy walrus? Whatever are you talking about? Let's go down south here, like he said, and see what's up with this lazy walrus. Because we do need to go to the Yarner Desert, so he did say it was south. There's another portal there, that's why it's going to be important to activate that other portal earlier on. Because that's going to get us back and forth. Hey there, guy! Bro, you are in the way, man! And you're dreaming about Marin?! Are you having a wet dream about Marin? He is, isn't he? And he's freaking in the way. Where's my polka flute?! Where's my polka flute, man?! I guess I have the song. I'm gonna play the song for him. Do I have the Poke Flute song? That would be awesome. Link, that doesn't even sound anything like the Ballad of the Windfish. Man, you suck at playing the ocarina. Alright, let's go get Marin, because she can sing the song way better than I can. Luckily, we have a warp here that will take us back. Before we do that, let's talk to somebody in here. I do have a delivery for Mr. Bear. Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work we go. Hey you, is that possibly a honeycomb you have there? I just ran out. Will you swap it for a pineapple? Yeah, of course I will. I love pineapple. Way more than honeycomb. You exchanged honeycomb for pineapple. It's not as sweet, but it's delicious. For shizzle, my nizzle. Hi-ho, hi... No, I'll stop that. Yeah, I know, that tub of goo is asleep right in the way to Yarna Desert. Once he's asleep, he won't budge for a long time. But hey, take little Marin and wake him up with her song. That slob will wake up with a jump if you heard her sing. Hehehe. That was kind of an evil laugh there, Mr. Bear. Hehehe. Kind of a little bit of a maniacal laugh going on. Alright, anyway, we have a warp back to Mabe Village, so let's go back and find Marin and see what Marin's doing on this lovely sunny day. Honestly, like, everybody's like, oh, you wake the windfish and get off this island, Link. But no, I rather stay on this island, honestly. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of monsters and it's a little bit dangerous, but if I just stayed in town all day, it's like a freaking vacation. Alright. Marin? What have you done with Marin? She likes to go stare at the ocean all by herself. Why? Hey, I'm just a kid, don't ask me. I like that they make the kids out in this game to, like, have no information, and yet they have the most helpful information of all of them, pretty much. Like the kid at the beginning of the game that tells you how to save the game. And they're like, oh, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Except that they do. Anyway, so down here. Hey there, kid. Speaking of you, you're the kid that told me how to save the game. The giant egg on top of Tamaranch Mountain. They say that's the windfish is sleeping inside of it. Why? I don't know either. See, the kids don't know anything, and yet they know everything, apparently. I don't know, I just find that funny. So anyway, Marin is down on the beach. We're gonna go to a new place on the beach that we've never been to and fight Gordos. Fight Gordos and other Kirby enemies. Lots and lots of references to other games. In fact, there's some characters even from other games in this one, not just references. So that's interesting. Hey there, monkey, how's it going? Ah, he's attacking! Oh, good lord. Anyway, we have a chest here, but we're gonna go see Marin on the next episode of Link's Awakening, so thank you all for watching. I've been Josh Jepson, and I will see you in the next one. Can I borrow it for a second? Yeah, you can borrow my stick, you damn pervert. What are you doing? What reason do you have for poking a beehive? Of course the bees are gonna chase you, dumbass!